If we now tried to run the application, the console window would close as soon as the main method was finished. To prevent this, we can add the get method, which belongs to the console input stream. This method reads input from the keyboard until the return key is pressed. We can now run the program by going up to debug and clicking start without debugging. Visual Studio then compiles and runs the application, which displays the text in the console window. When we then press the return key, the get method ends and thereby closes the program. As an alternative to using an IDE, we can also compile source files from the command line. To demonstrate, I've logged into a Linux server where I have uploaded this source file. From here, I can use the GNU C++ compiler, which is available on virtually all Unix systems. I type the compiler name G++ and give it the input and output file names as arguments. It then produces an executable, which when run gives the same result as the one compiled under Windows. Before we end this section, let's take a look at the two kinds of comment notations in C++, single line and multiline. These allow us to insert notes into our source code, and they will have no effect on the end program.